I was hired at the university as an ungulate habitat ecologist. Research that I'm doing right now with my graduate students in my lab and is understanding the effects of recolonizing carnivores, like restored gray wolves or recovering grizzly bears or mountain lions, on these cornerstone ungulate species like elk. It's not a very easy question to ask. Are carnivores actually having the effects that we think they're having, or people think they're having, on elk populations? The State Wildlife Agency is struggling to understand the effects of recovering carnivores, like wolves in this case, on elk, and are under intense public scrutiny. These agencies have a management issue, and I think because of the strong track record of the Wildlife Biology Program, Dan Pletcher and his students, Bart O'Gara and his students, they come to the Wildlife Biology Program. One of the things we have to remind ourselves about universities is we don't actually manage wildlife or conserve wildlife. All we do is teach and train and do research on how to do it. When I sort of look at our undergraduate students and graduate students, where they go and where their careers take them, I'm blown away how much luck they have. And the reason I think our students end up having such success getting jobs with real hands-on applied wildlife management agencies is because of the strong collaboration we have at our heart in pretty much all the undergraduate and especially graduate research that we do. So for me, I couldn't imagine teaching in a better place than Missoula, where all we have to do in the Wildlife Biology Program is sort of open our window and point at one of the most pressing conservation issues facing wildlife. I really think that in some ways Montana is sort of a proving ground. A lot of the things have become so advanced and so technologically driven, but fundamentally those kinds of technologies aren't really, I think, what conservation needs or what students need to really learn what it takes to do wildlife conservation. So until we sort of understand that wildlife conservation should be approached in a community-based conservation framework that sees to the needs of the people who live with the wildlife, we really won't be that successful. And I think that these are theoretical ways of understanding human-wildlife conflict and human and carnivore conflict that I've learned here firsthand by studying wolves, say, but that actually can translate immediately to help a Bhutanese wildlife manager understand, well, how do I keep tigers on the landscape? I mean, there's no reason why things we learn about wolves here shouldn't help us manage endangered carnivores around the world. We're not afraid at the Wildlife Biology Program. We've never been afraid, really, of asking really hard, challenging questions that challenge the status quo.